E scevere venna nadara va strongedere vennitsin. Mestus urus eftadara va planidi divides, gnadara il duruburu damun. Trialalara.
Welcome to Appieno. Welcome to Appieno. This is the name of the place where you are this moment. If I say welcome to the village of Appieno, the mayor might say, oh, village is a tiny word, because it's bigger than the village. It's a big community, actually, it's a community. And as you noticed, the village is in the middle of Cyprus, about between Larnaca and Nicosia. It's where we are this moment. So, Athieno is actually in the Larnaca district, okay, not in Nicosia district. And we are in the plain Messauria. So, Messauria is actually the area between the two mountains of Cyprus. The Pentadactylus mountain, which is behind us, and the mountain we saw yesterday, the Italian capital near Nicosia. And on the other side is the Turidos mountains, where we're going when we leave from Athieno. Okay, so it what the word Messauria means as well, in between the mountains. So we are on the plain. As you were coming towards the village, you noticed that it's an area where the Cypriots plant a lot of cereals, so it's a farming village actually. And you felt the smell from the dairy farms. There are two farms here, chicken farms, pig farms, so it's a farming area generally. So the people of Appieno are very progressive people. I mean, you can see that they try to do their best to have a good life. So there is an industrial area as well outside the village. And the village is very famous for bread making, and for cheese making as well. So we get the chance today to taste some fresh cheese and anari as well. I would love to welcome you on behalf of the mayor as well. Unfortunately, the mayor cannot be with us this morning because of the family. He's christening actually a grandchild today. So the whole family is very busy for the big event. Because, you know, christening here is one of the biggest events in Cyprus, because at the same time it's the day the baby takes the Holy Communion and it's the confirmation as well. So the family invites some people, so the godparents as well. So we are getting ready for this. Now, I know it's pretty warm. What I would like to tell you is that there are restrooms here if you want to use them. We are going to proceed and see a little bit the museum, which is a collection. Actually, it's a three-part museum, this one. It's the archaeological part, because we are in an area where there are many archaeological sites. Then we have a very well-known monk who became a monk, and he was very interested in Byzantine art. So he offered to Athieno a big part of his collection. His name is Kalinikos. This man offered as well this piece of land where we are at this moment. So this is the reason the town hall got the name Kalinikion Megaron. And they started to build about 10 years ago. It's a modern building, so when they did the competition about, let's say, the building, the thought of this building, it's like a farming kind of style of a building. Okay, and then we have the ethnographic part of the museum, where there you can see with what kind of work the local people used to work with. Okay?
The town of Athieno is located in the plain of Messauria, between the urban centers of Nicosia and Larnaca. Its history can be characterized over the years as diverse. A milestone of the recent history of the area has been the Turkish invasion of 1974, which established Athieno as a frontier area, since 65% of the town's territorial boundaries are under a legal Turkish occupation.
The town's population numbers 6,000 residents, whereas there are hundreds of people from Athieno who have emigrated mainly to Australia, Great Britain, and the USA. Archaeological excavations in the whited area of Athieno have brought to light ancient findings dated back to the Neolithic period, 8500 to 3900 BC.
Ever since the ancient times, the area has been inhabited and developed. As a result, the municipality is today well known both for its archaeological and cultural heritage and for its hard-working and progressive residents.
Athienou is famous for its traditional professions related to bakery and cheesemaking. It's also famous for exporting products both within Cyprus and abroad. The younger generations are particularly involved in sports and arts, painting, music, dancing and theater.
The religious tradition of the town is indicated by its four churches and four outdoor chapels standing around it.
The creation of the Kalinikio Municipal Museum of Athienou was a matter of time for the municipality, a place rich in cultural heritage whose existence is dated back to the ancient times. The museum, which is distinguished for its modern architecture, was named after monk Kalinikos Stavrovounios, a son and a benefactor of Athienou and an excellent icon painter. The inauguration ceremony of the museum was held on July 3rd in 2009 and performed by the Minister of Communications and Works Nikos Nikolaidis. The museum consists of the archaeological collection, the collection of ecclesiastical art and the ethnographic collection. It is housed in the Kalinikio Municipal Hall of Athienou along with the municipality of the town. The aim of the exhibition areas of the museum is to operate as a center of communication with the visitors, as a source of knowledge for both adults and children, to bring back memories of the past, to attract tourists and to give people the opportunity to become aware of our local and national history and culture. The archaeological collection of the museum consists of burial furnishing and dedications, which were mainly found in tombs and sanctuaries, respectively at the archaeological sites of Golgi, Malura and Bambulari of Kukuninas, as well as in various locations of the modern town of Athienou. The archaeological findings are from the late Bronze Age, 1600 to 1050 BC, and up to the Hellenistic period 310 to 38 BC. The observation and study of the ceramic vessels and the sculptures give the opportunity to the visitor to get to know both the habits and the folk ways of each period, as well as the features of handicrafting in Cyprus. The turbulent background of the archaeological excavations in Athienou has marked, in the same way as it did on the Tyre island, the knowledge about the past, sometimes with its scientific substantiation and on the other occasions with its huge criminal gaps. Excavations have been carried out in the wider region of Athienou ever since the middle of the 19th century. Thousands of antiquities today adorn museums and private collections abroad, including the Louvre Museum in Paris and the Metropolitan Museum of Art in New York, which was inaugurated by displaying the Cypriot collection of the well-known tomb raider Luigi Palma di Sensola. Excavations are still carried out at the site of Malura by the Athienou Archaeological Project led by Dr. Michael Dumazu and his team. The collection of ecclesiastical art. The largest part of the museum's collection of ecclesiastical art was created after the foundation of Father Kalinikos kindly offered portable icons and personal objects of Father Kalinikos to the museum. The collection consists of icons of Renaissance and Byzantine style, which were painted by Father Kalinikos, as well as of icons from his own personal collection. Also presented in the same room are aspects of his life, as well as the techniques of icon painting, which are characterized by the monk's own personal touch. The milestones in the life of Father Kalinikos have been his apprenticeship next to Ioannikios Mavropoulos, his 3 years-long imprisonment during the liberation struggle of EOKA from 1955 until 1959, and his apprenticeship next to icon painter Fotis Kondoglou. Part of this section was dedicated to the creation of an icon painting and mosaic workshop. displayed in this section are works by brothers Georgios and Alkis Kepolas. The Kepola brothers, sons of Athienou, envisaged the creation of this workshop, a place which mostly gives young people the chance for a healthy and creative exploitation of their free time. The Ethnographic Collection. The Ethnographic Collection completes a primary effort in describing the identity of Athienou and its past. Exhibits acquired from citizens, kind donations and from purchases are shedding light both to the daily life of people of Athienou in the 20th century as well as to moments of pleasure and formality. A journey of memory and nostalgia for those who have experienced the facts presented and a track of knowledge and respect for the younger generations constitute Athienou of the past and present. The theme units of the Ethnographic Collection are about entertainment, traditional professions, the history of Athienou as a municipality, sports life and Boy Scouts, educational institutions, as well as the participation of Athienou in the national struggles. Donations of objects which have the ability to narrate their own story to the visitors are welcome to enrich the ethnographic collection of the museum.
Che madaraba epse dere bendita daraba la san che si vivi cose dere dena piedere deragna dara luru damu tria la 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 tria la 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 tria la la